So I started building the 172nd scale RAS-30 or GP-03 Steinman, and I don't really know what I was expecting. So far, I did the stand. The stand is the first thing you're supposed to do, and I had problems with the LED wiring. I mean, I placed everything in the right spot, but the wires, like, one of them broke off the soldering point. And I'm not really good with soldering, and I don't really want to fight with it because the only reason it ripped is because trying to feed like three or four wires through the neck was really hard, at least for me. So at least one of the lights worked. The lights around the base work. You'll see that in the actual review. The other one might work. One of the three, because there's three buttons on the stand. One of them will not work. And I don't know what the other two are for exactly, so we'll find out. So that was weird, and also I was finding the parts weren't like pegging into place on the stand. And then I built the shield, which I really like the shield. I like how it looks. Although I don't like the fact that it doesn't split in half and fold like it's supposed to, which is one solid piece. Well, once you get all the parts on, it's pretty heavy, like the nice chrome on it. And I had to glue a lot of it together because I couldn't get it to stay together. I'm like, wow, this is starting to be very glue heavy. And then I got to the beam rifle, and yeah, everything had to be glued. It's really weird because there's tabs everywhere, but they just don't hold to save their lives. And this thing does take the RAM batteries. It's LR41. Which I was gonna order off Amazon, but when I was putting this together, two of the wires in the gun, they ripped off the soldering points, and I just gave up on that. I don't care enough about the LEDs. It would like light up the sensor here, and the and down here I think at the barrel, and in here. But it's a big hassle to try and solder them back on, and then still feed them through here without ripping them again, because there's so little space to work with. And also the fact that this is the energy clip. Those should be these last time I checked. Pretty sure. But they are not. Not even close. So that's. I don't think they're for the bazooka. I don't think this comes with the bazooka. These are the only weapons it has. As the beam rifle, the shield, and the beam sabers, which, well, they were easy enough to do. And the beams are nice and thick and chunky, so they're cool. And then I got to work on the torso. This is as far as I've got on the actual mobile suit. And this was just to get to this state was a huge pain in the ass. I don't understand how you can design a model that seems to peg together but not. Especially like this top part here that goes over the canopy, it doesn't go anywhere. It just lays, as far as I can tell, it just lays on top, and I had to glue it on. It doesn't. There's no pegging or anything. It just lays on top of the cockpit area. It's really weird. And I had to cut the pegs off the side here on the chest because they would not go together and line up with the parts back here. Yeah, the wiring back here, which, like I said, one of these might work, one of them might not. I don't know. The pistons were a huge pain in the ass to try to keep together and paint in here. The first photo etching parts are right here, and they look okay. So I'm assuming that will line up, and this will line up, which is gonna be the yellow piece there, which is nicely detailed. I'm just gonna go in here, and even though it has like a tab piece there, and at the bottom, it's not gonna stay. I'll have to glue it. Now, I thought, okay, this thing obviously is supposed to be glued. I can't believe it wouldn't be. But then, it still might be the case, but for the simple fact that certain areas, like that clear piece on the chest, you're supposed to glue it. Now, why would that be specific for that? That one piece. If you don't have to glue the entire kit, right? Like, what's the point of that? And see here, this little piece, it has to be glued in. But none of the other parts say that, even though everything basically does. Same thing here, these little piston pieces, they go together, they have to be glued. But they also have to be glued to stay in place. And there's no way those pistons would work. There's like two joints in the torso. I'm not trying it. I'm not gonna try to articulate this guy in the chest at least. So while it looks beautiful, if it looks like this when it's done, it is beautiful looking. And the plastic is good. But the fact that I have to glue everything, I don't like gluing. So that is definitely a turnoff. I glued kits when I was a kid. That's all there were. There were all staff together ones. Well, there are a few I had, but most of them were glued together, and I never liked it, and I still don't like it. And for me personally, it's not a fun build. I wish it was. Maybe I'll get into the rhythm and just glue and keep going, give it time to set. But it just, I don't know. I was hoping for something a little more fun, a little more just keep going. And it's not cheap. This thing's like, it was like $350, I think it was, is what I paid, I think. $350 or $400, God, it was not cheap. So I think for that much, they should be, like, the pegs should be able to be, like, pegged together. Like, this thing should be able to be assembled without glue and everything. I understand the photo etch parts and some other little areas, like the clear piece and the chest, but I don't think the entire thing should have to be glued, like, all these little things have to be glued in there, the pipes and the wires, little chrome piece here, and these little gray bits, the vent, like, it's just a big pain in the bum. Finally got the cockpit door to stay on. It's kind of disappointing, but I'm gonna keep doing it, because I think it's gonna look cool, especially next to my perfect grade, GP01. I just want to talk about that, because it's weird. Like, am I just weird? Am I the weird one? And I should be like, yeah, glue, who cares? Just do it. But I don't know, I don't like gluing, personally. I think it should be, and like I said, for the price. If third parties can do that stuff, that Nielsen work kit, even though it was, like, modified from a master grade into a 160 scale, a few things I think had to be glued on that. I think if you're going to be asking a premium for your models, they shouldn't be, and they peg together. They do peg together, but they just don't hold together. It's really weird. I don't know. I just want to talk about it because it was kind of bumming me out. So anyways, I'll keep going with the build and I'll see you in the next review.